हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज अवर टॉपिक इज सीरीज एलसीआर सर्किट बाय फेजर मेथड। एज यू सी इन सर्किट वी हैव थ्री कंपोनेंट्स, रेजिस्टर, इंडक्टर एंड कैपेसिटर व्हिच आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज। क्लियर? विथ सप्लाई एप्सिलॉन इक्वल टू एप्सिलॉन नॉट साइन ओमेगा टी। वी नो द वोल्टेज अक्रॉस द रेजिस्टर is VR is equal to I into R, while voltage across inductor is VL is equal to I into XL, that is inductive reactance. Then voltage across capacitor is I into XC, which is voltage capacitive reactance, right? So these are the three voltages that we are getting in the series connection, right, of LCR. Now we know that the current relation in resistor with voltage are in phase, means current and voltage are in same phase. So if you plot a line of current, then voltage will also come in a same direction. Clear? In inductor, we know that the current is lagging behind voltage by phase angle pi by 2. So here if we place draw line of current, then voltage should be ahead. Right? This is the voltage VL. As you see, this current is lagging behind, or voltage is leading current by phase angle pi by 2 in inductor. While in capacitor, current is leading voltage by phase angle pi by 2. So if we draw a line of current, this is supposed to be the current I, then here it should be the voltage across capacitor. Or you can see this voltage is lagging behind current by phase angle pi by 2. So this is the phase angle pi by 2. Now on this basis, if you draw a phasor diagram, then as you see, the supply makes an angle of omega t with an x-axis, then suppose this is the voltage vector, which is epsilon naught, amplitude of voltage, which makes an angle of omega t here. Right, this is the angle which it make. Now then if we draw a vector for resistor, then current will also come in the same direction. Then suppose this is voltage vector, then current will also come in the same directions. This is the current. Clear? Now we know that for inductor, voltage is leading current. So if current vector is here, then voltage should be ahead with an angle of pi by 2. So if we plot a vector of voltage, suppose this is the voltage of inductor VL, right, which makes an angle of pi by 2, with current. As you see, this angle is pi by 2 with current, right? So this is the vector of inductor. Now for voltage vector of capacitor, it is lagging behind current by pi by 2. So if it current is here, then it will be behind the current vector, so which with a angle of pi by 2. So if you draw another vector here, right, this is supposed to be the VC, voltage of capacitor, then again it makes an angle of pi by 2 with current, right? This VC makes an angle of pi by 2 with current. So this is what the vector phasor diagram, right? Now in this we are letting that VL is greater than VC. Friends, remember here, we are letting that VL vector is greater than VC, or you can say that inductive reactance is greater than capacitive reactance. Then by that, the resultant, this vector VL and VC both are in opposite direction. So the resultant vector supposed to be this, right? Up to here, this vector is VL minus VC, right? This much is cancelled from VL, then the resultant is VL minus VC. This is the resultant vector. Then by plotting a parallelogram, right, this is the parallelogram formed here, right? As you see, the current and voltage makes an angle of phase difference of phi. Here, by plotting a diagram, right, from this, triangle is like this. This is VR with epsilon naught, and here is another vector which is VL minus VC. Clear? And this angle is phase angle phi. Here this is VR and this is epsilon naught. Right? From this only, if we try to draw a triangle of impedance, then suppose the triangle of impedance is like this. This line represents the resistance, right? From voltage VR, if you represent a resistance line, then this is VR. Other line is this, right? From this VL minus VC, the reactance is, it is XL minus XC, right? It is XL minus XC. Then here we get another hypotenuse, that is impedance, right? This is the triangle of impedance, which is very important. Suppose here we have vertices O, this is supposed to be the P, and this is A. Then this is triangle impedance triangle, right? This is impedance triangle. Friends, this is very important triangle. Remember this. When this is a case of when XL is greater than XC, when inductive reactance is greater than capacitive reactance, right? That time it is a case. Now from this triangle, if we use a Pythagoras theorem, then using Pythagoras theorem, for this triangle using Pythagoras, we write it is epsilon naught square is equal to VR square plus VL minus VC whole square. Then it is epsilon naught square is equal to, what is VR? It is I naught into R whole square plus what is VL? It is I naught into XL, that is inductive reactance, minus I naught into XC, that is capacitive reactance whole square. Then I naught square in a bracket, this term is R square plus XL minus XC whole square, clear? Epsilon naught square is equal to, therefore this term is I naught is equal to, it is epsilon naught by under root of R square plus it is XL minus XC whole square. This is the amplitude of current for series LCR. Clear? Or you can write this equation as I naught is equal to epsilon naught by under root of R square plus XL is omega L, So it is omega L. While Xc is 1 by omega C. So it is 1 by omega C whole square. Right? This is another form of inductive reactance or amplitude of current for series LCR. Now, if we write a phase angle, then as you see, this triangle, impedance triangle, is very important, right? From this impedance triangle, if we write a phase angle, then phase angle is 10 phi is equal to 10 phi for this triangle, it is opposite upon adjacent. So it is XL minus XC by R. Clear? If you substitute the value of XL and XC, then it is omega L minus 1 by omega C whole by R. This is what the phase angle. Clear? This is what the phase angle. Or also you can also write the phase angle in terms of cos. So cos phi is equal to, for this triangle, cos phi is equal to, it is adjacent upon hypotenuse. So for this triangle, adjacent is R and hypotenuse is Z. So cos phi is equal to R by Z. Clear? Cos phi is equal to R by Z. This is the phase angle for series LCR. Clear? Now, from this, if we see the special cases, then, or before that, we are going to see the effective resistance, right? That is where impedance, this is the impedance Z, where root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square is the effective resistance of the series LCR circuit. Clear? Which opposes the flow of AC supply. So it is called impedance, which is denoted by Z. Simply Z is equal to, right? Simply Z is equal to, that is, Z is equal to under root of R square plus, it is XL minus XC whole square, or equal to under root of R square plus, XL is omega L minus XC is 1 by omega C whole square. Clear? Now let's see the special cases, which are very important. So, special cases, right? Let's say the special cases. Number one, first is when XL is equal to XC, right? If XL means inductive reactance is equal to capacitive reactance, then from this phase angle, as you see, XL, if XL is equal to XC, then this term is zero, right? If this term is zero, then cos phi is equal to zero. Then we can write, it is 10 phi is equal to 0. Therefore, phi is equal to 0. Right? If 10 phi is equal to 0, then flux phi is equal to 0. From this, we can conclude that, hence, voltage and current are in the same phase, right? Because as you see, phase angle is zero, means there is no difference between voltage and current. So that are called, it is voltage and current are in same phase. Then AC circuit is non-inductive or purely resistive. Right, non-inductive or purely resistive, right, when XL is equal to XC. Clear? Then second special case is number 2, when XL is greater than XC. If XL is greater than XC, then as you see, this is our equation, right? If XL is greater than XC, then tan phi is equal to positive term. Means whatever a term comes, it is positive. So if tan phi is positive, then flux phi is also positive. Clear? So tan phi is positive. Therefore, flux phi is positive. From this, we get the conclusion, that is, hence, voltage leads the current by phase angle phi. Then, such AC circuit is inductance dominated circuit. Inductance dominated circuit, or it is called inductive circuit. Clear? Inductance dominated circuit or inductive circuit, because in inductance we know that the voltage is leading current, right? So this happens when XL is greater than XC. So such AC circuit is inductive circuit or inductance dominated circuit. Now in third special case, that is when XL is less than XC. As you see from this equation, if XL is less than XC, then the resultant is negative. So tan phi is negative. If tan phi is negative, then flux phi is negative. Clear? Tan phi is negative. Therefore, flux phi is negative. From this, we can write, hence, voltage lags behind current by phase angle phi. Then such AC circuit is capacitance dominated circuit or capacitive circuit. Clear? This is what the series LCR, we get very important equation in the series LCR. This is the phase angle equation is very important, right? These are the special cases. This is the impedance which we are getting for series LCR. This is the amplitude of current, right? And very important impedance triangle, which is very important for other theory also, right? So remember this impedance triangle. Thank you.